say nothing, do nothing, get nothing. Follow along.
You're watching DC Born Rob, Erasing Borders. And now, the news.
Okay, good morning, good evening, good afternoon, wherever it is you're located. Thanks for watching. My name is DC Born Rob, also known as Rob. Thank you guys for watching. In this video, again, I am requesting your assistance with reaching out to the representatives of the Reed family and the Stevenson brothers in Ecuador. We need your assistance now because the Secretary of State is headed to both Ecuador and Colombia this week. Within the next day, actually, I believe he's going to be in Ecuador first, starting tomorrow, and then half the day on the 20th, he's going to switch over to Bogota, Colombia. They're meeting with the heads of state there, the President, Duque, are all meeting together. So this is an important time for you guys to reach out. Like the title of this video says, if you say nothing and do nothing, guess what? You're going to get nothing. There'll be no changes done if you don't do anything about it. Remember the saying, the squeaky wheel gets the oil? Well, that's true. So I'm looking for people of integrity who can actually reach out, take that extra step and make a phone call or send an email. I actually had somebody reach out to me from Morehouse College. And let me tell you something. That warmed my heart to hear that one of these Morehouse men are actually reaching back. And he graduated around the same time, he says, that Mr. Reed did. So we need the assistance from everyone out there, from all my viewers, to make a couple of phone calls, send a couple of emails. Again, if you need a sample text, I can send that to you. Send your request to me at dcbornrobgroup@gmail.com. dcbornrobgroup@gmail.com, and we'll get you going. But we need your assistance now. All the information and the people that you need to reach out in each case is listed below, as well as reach out to the embassy if you can on behalf of the three lost lives the first week of September. There's been no resolution for that. And the website that the State Department gives us only tracks deaths up until June of 2021. So it's not going to help us in July, August, September. Now, it's not going to help us. We need you guys to be that squeaky wheel. Something can get done. I have one quick story. I have a new employee here, and I want to bring her on right quick just to have her speak on a certain story that shows that being the squeaky wheel can actually get results. So up to you, Sonia.
Thanks, DC Rob. This story is from Wired.com. Last year, a military veteran living in Massachusetts's 6th Congressional District tossed aside a piece of mail from the Veterans Administration without realizing that the information he needed to access his benefits was buried at the end of the 6-page letter. Once he realized his mistake, he called the office of Seth Moulton, his representative. He said, "I realize they sent a letter, and I should read every line, but come on. 6 pages, and you're putting this in the last paragraph." Recalls Andy Flick, Moulton's deputy chief of staff. Caseworkers in Moulton's office helped the man sort out his problems with the VA, but they also brought the issue to Moulton's legislative team to see if they could help fix the underlying system that created such a clunky letter. Now that team is drafting a piece of legislation, tentatively named the Too Long, Didn't Read Act, which would require government agencies to spell out actionable steps for constituents in a black box on the front page of any piece of mail. It's a simple ask, but Flick says it shows what can happen when Congress functions the way it's supposed to. If that person had been silently frustrated, then people across the country would continue to be silently frustrated, says Flick. Because he called in, members like Seth are able to take measurable steps to fix it. Of course, Congress hasn't functioned the way it's supposed to in quite a while. That's one reason why last summer, the nonprofit OpenGov Foundation sent teams to shadow 58 congressional staffers in 20 offices across the country, including Moulton's. Their objective? To study exactly what happens to every call, email, letter, and yes, even fax, Congress receives, and figure out what resonates and why. Founded by Republican Congressman Daryl Issa and his former staffer Seamus Kraft in 2012, the OpenGov Foundation today published the results of that research. It provides a blueprint not only for congressional offices pushing for more efficient tools to track public input, but for advocacy groups vying to be heard, and for technology companies that could help the two better connect. If you're a constituent and you get an email that says to call Congress and tell them X, Y, or Z, you're sold on the idea that it's going to make a difference, Kraft says. But is it? The OpenGov Foundation report, shared exclusively with Wired, shows that despite how fractured Congress appears, constituent outreach really can work, just not in the ways you might assume. There's more to this story, so stay tuned. But remember, if you say nothing and do nothing, you'll get nothing. Back to you, DC Rob.
So you've heard the story. We need you to reach out now on behalf of the Stevenson brothers who have been wrongfully accused of murder in Ecuador and sentenced to 34 years. 34 years for a crime that they did not commit. Do due diligence by all means and look into the case. Ask us for information. I hope to bring the brothers back on soon weekend morning when we can both have the time together. Also, look out for the Reed family. You know, it's a strange coincidence that when the Secretary of State is going to be in Colombia is exactly 6 months to the day since the death of Timothy Reed Sr. Now, I've been told from people in Colombia that after the six-month period, things tend to drop off. It's forgotten. Well, from what I can tell right now, things have been forgotten from the day it happened, or at least a week or two after that. Nothing has been done. We need you to help put the pressure. Remember, the squeaky wheel gets the oil. If you say nothing and you do nothing, well, nothing is going to happen. There'll be no change. Again, I'm looking for my viewers of integrity who can see wrong when they know it. Do something about it. Reach out. Make a phone call. Make a call. Email. WhatsApp. Any communication that you can. We need your help now. We need your assistance. Again, for all you travelers, be safe.